Hey everyone, welcome to a new tutorial. In this video I will show you how to make a triangle shawl featuring a big rose in the center. This shawl is made using the filet crochet technique and the written pattern is available on my website. I will put the link in the description below. If this is the first time you're watching my videos, please subscribe to my channel and click on that bell button. This way you will receive notifications when I upload new free patterns. For this shawl, you will need 2 balls of my merino, which is fingering weight yarn, and you will need crochet hook size 4 mm. Here you can find the graph that you will need to follow. You can also find the graph on my website. The link can be found in the description below. Each box represents 2 stitches. White means we work a double crochet stitch in the next stitch. We chain 1 and skip the next stitch. Black means we work 2 double crochet stitches. So let's start with row 1. We will make a slip knot and chain 5. This will count as your first double crochet and a chain 1. Now we work a double crochet in the 5th chain from the hook. We turn our work and we now have 1 chain space. In row 2 we will chain 4. Which counts as your first double crochet and chain 1. We work a double crochet in the first stitch. Chain 1. And we work a double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in the last stitch. We now have 3 chain spaces. In row 3, we will chain 4, work a double crochet in the first stitch, and we repeat the following. We chain 1, skip the next chain space, and work a double crochet in the next double crochet. Repeat this to the end. At the end we will chain 1 and work a double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in the last stitch. We turn our work and we have 5 chain spaces. All we need to do now is repeat row 3 until row 72 while following the chart. We are now in row 6 and here I will make the first black square, which means we work a double crochet instead of a chain. So here you can see I started the row with chain spaces. And now you can see I'm working a double crochet in the next chain space instead of a chain. And now I will continue the row with chain spaces because this row only has 1 black square, so we only need 1 double crochet. As you can see, in the next few rows there are no black squares, so I can just continue working a chain space in every stitch and increase in the first and last stitch. I'm working on row 7 and I will show you what to do when there's a white square over a black square, we chain one, we skip the next double crochet, and work a double crochet in the next stitch. And then we continue till the end. Here's a trick how I keep track of my progress. I usually send a photo to myself or to my mom or husband, and I will use the paint tool to keep track of the row that I just finished. So as you can see, I just worked chain spaces, and I will now show you how to work a black square over a black square. So we just work a double crochet in the next double crochet. And another double crochet in the next double crochet. This equals one black square. Now I need to make another black square. So again, I will work two double crochet stitches. Now I have to work a white square, so I chain one, I skip the next chain space, and work a double crochet in the next stitch. And again, a black square, so I work two double crochet stitches. So then there is a white square, so I chain one, skip the next chain space, and work a double crochet in the next. And then there are two black squares, so I work a double crochet in the next four stitches. Then there is a white square, so I make a chain space by chaining one. And that's basically it. You just follow the graph. A white square means a chain, and a black square means a double crochet. So just go ahead and repeat this till the end of the graph, which means you will have a total of 72 rows. I will see you at the end. Optionally, you can add some tassels, and I will quickly show you how I made them. I used a clover tassel maker, but you can also use your hand or your phone or a book. And that's it. I hope you guys liked this tutorial. Please give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comments which yarn and colors you are going to use. Hope to see you next time. Bye!